Hi, Georgie. Do you want your boat? No? Are you here to watch Tom Richardson's movie review of It, the 2017 remake, that doesn't use Tim Curry's voice that this guy seems to be using? Huh? Is that what you want? Do you want his review of the movie? Well, I guess I'll get out of here, but don't forget, they all float, and if you want your boat back, you'll have to come back to the sewer and float too.
Hey guys, so as you can tell, I was using Tim Curry's Pennywise voice for the Bill Skarsgård pop vinyl of Pennywise. So this is what he looks like in the new movie I'm going to review for you today. So yes, the 2017 remake of It is finally out. I'm a huge fan of the miniseries that came out in 1990 of the story of It. I personally have never read the novel, but I know a lot of people who did, and I know a lot of people who have... pointed out some pretty significant differences between the miniseries and the book, and thus far of the differences between this movie, this new one, and the book and the miniseries. So there's basically three different ways to interpret this story, and all three of them seem to be using a different kind of direction for these characters and so forth, but they all seem to follow the same core story. And that same core story for the synopsis of this movie as well is these kids live in Derry, Maine. It's a fictional town in Maine that Stephen King seems to use in a lot of his stories. And these young kids are all being terrorized by this clown that seems to either invade their dreams, invade their nightmares, or takes form of something that they're afraid of. So if you're afraid of spiders, he would take form of a spider. If you're afraid of blood, he would somehow... be able to shoot blood at you and stuff like that. So they do different things for each kid with this Pennywise character. And so they all come together. They kind of all truthfully say to each other that, you know, they're all being terrorized by this clown. They want it to stop. The dreams are getting worse the more they kind of let this go and let this clown basically continue to do these horrible things to them. One of these kids lost his brother, the Pennywise. Pennywise basically dragged him down to the sewers and ate him pretty much. So basically this clown's no good. He's basically hurting this town. People are kind of just letting this go, not talking about it, not doing anything about it. But a lot of people seem to be aware of this clown and they just kind of ignore it and go about their jobs and so forth. So basically these young kids come together, they form something called the Losers Club. And so they go down to the sewers themselves to try to take care of this clown once and for all, so that this clown problem that they've been constantly having all the time will probably and hopefully go away for good. So overall, guys, I really like this remake of the It movie. Of you know, it's the remake of the miniseries from 1990. I really think they did a great job here. Normally, I'm not a big fan of remakes, but I really liked how this remake specifically, they took something that was already made, you know, from the miniseries and from the book and so forth, and they managed to take their own direction with this. I liked how they went with a more Stand By Me kind of direction where, you know, it was in the 80s. They definitely reference 80s culture a lot. They reference New Kids on the Block and films that came out in the 80s like Batman and the Nightmare on Elm Street series. And I think they reference Lethal Weapon at one point. So basically, yeah, they reference a ton of stuff that came out during the 80s that, you know, a lot of people really like to this day. They definitely, like I said, for Stand By Me, they definitely did like unique personalities for the kids that worked for the things that they were afraid of and so forth. So they really did a great job here. I really thought that they really kind of took the story into itself, and rather than just copy and pasting from what was already made as the miniseries, they really went in its own direction and they brought something unique and interesting to the story that we haven't seen for the overall It story yet. So from my positives and negatives of the It remake, I really, really liked the cast they had for who played the kids. I thought each kid who of the Losers Club was really, really talented. Even the bullies who were picking on the kids throughout the course of the film, I thought were really, really talented too. A lot of them really feel like they've been in the film business for a while. And I think a lot of them, this is either their first role or kind of their first bigger role from something small. So I really thought that the talented young child cast that they gathered for this film was really, really talented and really worthwhile for this movie. I also thought Bill Skarsgård played a very scary Pennywise in this movie. Another thing that he did that I really liked is he really went a different direction with Pennywise than Tim Curry did. Tim Curry, for me, was more of like a dark comedy, kind of like a bothersome clown, I guess, in a sense. But Bill Skarsgård Pennywise is more, he really wants to terrify you. He's out to scare you. He's not in it for the dark comedy at all. He just really wants to terrify you. And I really think that's what works about him, is the fact that he's really not there to make you laugh or anything like that. He really is there to kind of get what he wants, to scare you. Kind of has a more childlike quality to him than the Tim Curry Pennywise did. I'm not saying that he's a better Pennywise, and I'm not saying that Tim Curry was a better Pennywise, but I am going to say that I think Bill Skarsgård is the scarier Pennywise, which I think some people are probably going to want out of this movie, is a scarier Pennywise than what Tim Curry did. But one thing I think that Tim Curry did do that I think Bill Skarsgård didn't do as much, well, this isn't bad on either of their part, it was just both actors doing their own thing and trying to bring this character to life in their own way. I thought Tim Curry's Pennywise had a little bit more personality behind him. Like, there's certain things and certain cues that he would do that would either spark more so horror or more so spark a dark comedy kind of approach. Like I said, perfectly fine for both actors. I really like how both of them are kind of, you know, obviously Tim Curry wasn't able to respect it because, you know, he thought his was the only thing that they were going to do for back when they made that. But now that Bill Skarsgård's doing it, now that he's aware that, you know, the Tim Curry one has been around for a while and he really has to do his own thing for it to work, I thought his scarier interpretation of Pennywise was the right way to go, and kind of adding his own stamp to the character. I also liked all the nods to the and references to the 80s pop culture. You know, I think I talked about this briefly earlier with New Kids on the Block and Nightmare on Elm Street and Batman and all that. I really liked how they referenced all that. You know, I think there's even a scene where one of the kids has like a Beetlejuice poster on his wall and so forth. So small things like that I thought were kind of cool to really feel like you were in the 80s and experiencing something that was kind of popular for that time that kids are really into. So I thought that was a really cool thing they did for this movie. I also like how smooth the runtime felt in this movie. You know, for being a 2-hour-and-15-minute movie, I really did not get that impression at all. I really was into this movie. It's one of those movies where I almost kind of didn't want it to end just because I was so invested in these kids, and I wanted them to get rid of this clown character for all because, you know, once and for all, because I really knew that they had troubles with him and they wanted to get rid of him and, you know, move on with their lives and so forth. So it really is a smooth runtime. You really feel like, it really doesn't feel like 2 hours and 15 minutes just because it is so smooth and clear and, you know, aware of what direction it's going in and so forth. So it's just a very smooth movie. So for being 2 hours and 15 minutes, do not worry about the runtime at all. It's so smooth and so, you know, entertaining that you really kind of forget that you're in that theater for 2 hours and 15 minutes. It really is very smooth. Another thing that this film did too that I think that they did better than the miniseries is they made it more than just a horror story. Not only is it scary, but it's also funny and it's also charming and it's also mysterious all at once. I really do like how they added all these subgenres to this movie without it making feel like it's too different of a movie. So I really liked how they were able to make it scary and make it funny and making it charming all at once. I really do feel like it adds more dimension to this movie, and it makes it more, it has more of a layered feeling to it, that there's, you know, not just about the scares, it's not just about the humor, it's not just about these kids, it's not just about the mystery of the town of Derry. It really is all these things at once, and it all meshes well at once because it's so aware of what direction it's going in, and it's so clear of what it wants out of itself that all these subgenres manage to work within the context of this horror story. And that goes up to my next positive, which I like the mysteries of Derry, Maine. I really like how there's just enough mystery there, but there's just enough explanation where you can explain what Derry, Maine is like and kind of how eerie and creepy it is, while also kind of having that mystery of, you know, people really don't talk about this, but they seem aware of this other thing. And I like how they have this sense of mystery to this town of Derry, Maine. And then I also went over this briefly, too. I like how they had more of a Stand By Me kind of approach with this. You know, the miniseries was kind of its own thing, and that's perfectly fine. But I did like how they managed to add kind of another Stephen King story into this one by making it more of something that's more so Stand By Me, but also making it work for the story of It. So I think that that's really neat because that really kind of respects the work of Stephen King while also going its own direction, while also kind of respecting the miniseries for those who are like me and really enjoy that still. So I really like how it really went its own direction. It's respecting the book and the miniseries that came before while still doing its own thing. And I really like that about this movie is, It's a remake that's really aware of what came before it, while also pursuing its own interests, while also pursuing its own direction, and its own direction happens to be very different from the things that came before it. So I really like that a lot about this movie. Now, for my negatives of this new remake, one thing I thought the miniseries did better than this movie is I thought it had a better sense of character development. There is good character development in this movie per se, but I think it's stronger in the miniseries because in that, not only do they show how horrible kind of their home lives can be, but they also showed, like for example, with Ben, kind of how his dad passed away in the army in the miniseries, and kind of how that's bothering him and kind of how that hurts him making new friends. They showed quite a bit with Beverly, so I'm not going to pick on her. They do show her home life quite a bit. But like the things with Bill, I think they could have done more with that. Because in the miniseries, you know, like when he's looking through the photo book, it starts to bleed and stuff like that. So they show more of the kid's home life in the miniseries, at least in my opinion they do. And they show it more accurately in the sense of character development. They do it here a little bit, but they don't do it enough where I can perfectly say that the character development is 100% on point. So that is one thing about this movie I thought that could have been more improved. I also thought some of the CGI in this film was a little noticeable, specifically when the Bill Skarsgård Pennywise is like opening up his mouth and he has like all these layers of teeth and stuff. Some of it is a little CGI-ish to me. I really would have preferred more of a practical approach like what they did with the original miniseries, or at least make it look like it's seamless and a part of that world, because there's just certain scenes here where like where Bill Skarsgård is trying to scare somebody and he has this huge, you know, over-exaggerated background behind him or something. And it really does look very green screen CGI-ish. So that's one part of the movie to me that I thought could have been more improved as well. I also thought the school scenes were really, really brief in this movie. You know, we see them in school for a little bit, and I understand it's the end of the school year and so forth, so they really can't play off of that too much. But one thing I think they did do in the miniseries too that I liked better was the fact that they made it happen during the school year, showed more of their characters, showed more of their fears. Like they showed Richie's fear of werewolves by making it in the school longer and so forth. And because the school year is so short in this movie, we really don't get to see like Richie's fear of werewolves or anything like that. So I think the school scenes could have been lengthened more. I thought they could have played around with that a little bit more. But overall, guys, I really like this movie a lot. I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10. Really was impressed with this remake. Really was impressed with the young cast they gathered for this. Could have used a better sense of character development. The CGI could have been a little bit better for me. And like I said, the school scenes I thought could have been a little bit longer than what they went with. But overall, I was really impressed with this remake. I hope you guys enjoy this movie too. I'm still kind of on the fence of which one I like better, because I think the miniseries does its own thing in the right way in its own direction, and this does its own thing in the right direction just perfectly fine too. So I think there's things about both that you can like and dislike at the same time. So I don't know. I think they're both really good. So if you like the miniseries, I think you're going to like this film as well. So 9 out of 10 for me. Highly recommend the It movie. It's a very good time at the theater.